Hi everyone, happy new year. This is the first video of 2021. I am so pleased that you are joining me for this first practice. If you don't know me, my name is Elise and you are on my channel. Today you are for quite a dynamic vinyasa flow. Lots of half moon, reverse half moon, a bit of balancing pose. Grab a block if you have a block. If you don't have a block, a big book will do the trick. Grab a strap. If you don't have a strap, a scarf will do the trick. Maybe have a big glass of water before we start. Hop on your mat and let's get started. All right, welcome. You can come to a comfortable seated position. You can grab the flesh or the muscle of your bum, remove it back so you have a really nice anchor through the sit bones. Roll your shoulders back, open your chest, slide your shoulder blades down your back. Let your arms be relaxed, heavy on the laps. Grow the spine tall, reach the crown of the head towards the ceiling and close your eyes gently. As usual, we just take a moment to settle in. Take a moment to land on your mat. And you can leave aside anything that doesn't belong on your mat, anything that doesn't belong to your yoga practice. It's about 1 hour of self-care, 1 hour for yourself, your body, your breath. So you can start by connecting to your breathing. Without changing anything, just observe. Observe the flow of the breath. Observe the chest rising as you inhale, falling as you exhale. Relax your face. Soften all the muscles in your face, especially the muscles we use when we think too hard or when we worry. The forehead, the muscles around the eyes, the space between the eyebrows and the eyebrows. Separate your teeth so you can also relax the jaw. Soften the upper body, the shoulders, the back, the chest, the belly. Your arms, your hands. And soften the legs, the hips, the feet. And every time you exhale, you can release any tension you might have, whether it's emotional or physical tension. Let your exhale help you soften a little bit more. And here you can set an intention for your practice, for this first practice of 2021 together. What brings you on your mat? What can yoga do for you? Now take a deep breath through the nose and a big open mouth exhale. And again, inhale deeply through the nose. And big open mouth exhale. one last time. Deep, deep, deep inhale. And exhale. And now seal the lips. And you can find your ujjayi breath. Ujjayi breath is inhaling and exhaling through the nose with a constriction of the muscles at the back of the throat. So you can hear the ocean when you breathe. It's also called our veil breath. And it's a breath that helps you find strength, stamina, stability, and that will really help you remain present throughout the practice. Now bring your hands in front of your heart. Rub the palms together, create some heat. Cup the palms in front of the eyes. Feel the vibration, the energy you've created. Then bring your eyes open, spread your fingers, and release. All right, you can come on to all fours. All right, let's warm up the spine. On all fours, just remind you the alignment. Make sure that your wrists are under the shoulders, fingers are open, knees under the hips, and the feet disappear behind the knees. Now press on the hands, so you don't want to, you really want to press with the whole of the hand, not just the fingertips of the heel of the hand, like the whole hand is really pressing on the floor. Now as you inhale, drop the belly, arch the back, look up, open the chest. As you exhale, you press on the floor, you round the upper back, you tuck the chin, the tailbone. Two more. Inhale to a cow, drop the belly, arch the back, tailbone lift, look up. Exhale, press firmly on the floor, use the core, round the upper back, tailbone in, navel in, tuck the chin. One more time, inhale to open. And as you exhale, you round, imagine you want to send your heart to the ceiling, press, 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 use the core. And back to a neutral spine. All right, now extend the right leg back and flex the foot. Engage the core. Try to be stable here. Try not to open the hip. Imagine I put a yoga block on your sacrum. It needs to stay in this position. It can't move. And now lift the left arm forward. Pinky toe towards the ceiling. If you don't find stability, you can always step the toes of the left foot on the floor. And you get someone at the short edge of the mat, somewhere towards the short edge of the mat. Now, as you inhale, lift. And as you exhale, round knee to nose or elbow to knee. Inhale, lengthen and lift. And exhale, round. Press the floor with that right hand. Inhale, lengthen and lift. Last time, exhale to round. Inhale, hold here for 3, 2, 1, and release. Good. Let's change side. Extend the left leg. Flex the foot. Again, imagine that block on your sacrum. And when you find your stability, you can reach the right arm forward with the pinky toe facing the floor. Open the fingers. Look towards the front edge of the mat. Activate the core. Now, as you inhale, lift. And as you exhale, round knee to nose or elbow to knee. Press on the left hand. Inhale to lift and lengthen. Exhale to round. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale to round. Inhale, lift, stay. For 3, 2, 1, and release. Good. Now extend the right leg and tuck the toes on the floor. Press on the hands and let's find your high plank. So when you are in your high plank, you really want to have the heels, imagine your heels are pressing against the wall. So the heels are right above the balls of the feet. Rest underneath the shoulders. You press on the hands, but you gently soften the elbows. You don't want to lock your elbows. You gaze between the thumb. Activate the core. And breathe. Now inhale. And as you exhale, lift the hips and find your first downward dog. Walk the dog. You can walk in the position, lift one heel after the other. Bend the knees. Shift the hips from one side to the other. Maybe gaze underneath one armpit and then underneath the other armpit. Any movement here to loosen up the back of the legs and the rest of the body, really. And then find some stillness. So let's check this first downward dog, shall we? So you want to have the fingers open. And again, you press with the whole of the hands. So the weight is equally distributed between the feet and the hands. Your feet are about hip distance apart. Now, the idea is to stretch the spine. So if the heels are lifted, it's fine. It doesn't matter if you can't reach the heels for now. So you can keep a soft bend in the knees so you can really elongate the spine. Make sure you gaze towards the back of the mat, towards the knees, towards the ankle, so your neck is free. Externally rotate the shoulders away from the ears. Tailbone is lifted up and then press it back. And you want to sink the chest towards the thighs. Good. Try to remember these cues, this alignment. And breathe. Now look forward. Step the right foot and the left foot at the front of the mat. Inhale halfway up. Lengthen the spine, reach the crown of the head forward. You can slightly gaze down, tuck the chin if you need to, and gently squeeze the shoulder blades. The weight is towards the ball of the feet. Use the core to lift yourself up. Inhale here. And as you exhale, bend the knees, find your ragdoll pose. You can grab opposite elbows, or you can leave the top of the hands on the floor. Can keep a nice bend in the knees, but make sure the weight is towards the balls of the feet more than towards the heels. You can sway from side to side, find a bit of movement. Maybe here you can again bend one knee after the other. And then find stillness. Bring your hands in front of your feet. Now bend the left knee a lot, straighten the right leg. Left hand is in front of the left foot, and as you inhale, you open to the right. And you find a gentle twist here. You gaze towards the right thumb, or you gaze down, see what your neck allows here. Take a big inhale. As you exhale, lower the right hand down, right hand in front of the right foot. Bend the right knee a lot, straighten the left leg, and as you inhale, twist to the left. And again, you gaze up towards the left thumb, or you gaze towards the floor, see what the neck allows. Inhale, and as you exhale, release. Now bring the hands on the hips, bend the knees, press on the feet, and as you inhale, rise up. Let your arms travel all the way above the head. Join the palms together, interlace the fingers, but release the index. And relax the shoulders. Pelvis forward, tailbone down. Inhale, reach your fingertips to the ceiling. And as you exhale, side bend to the right. Look up, open the chest. Feel the whole of the left side stretching, elongating, creating space. Inhale to the center. And as you exhale, side bend to the left. So now you're stretching the whole of the right side, creating space here. Breathe through your right side. Inhale to reach. Exhale, bring the arms behind the body. Interlace the fingers here again. Release the index. Inhale, open the chest, look up. As you exhale, bend the knees, fall forward. Bring the fingertips towards the front of the mat, the index towards the front of the mat. Again, make sure the weight is more towards the balls of the feet.
and breathe. One more full cycle of breath here. Now press on the feet. As you inhale, rise, lift the arms above the head. And exhale, hands to the heart and release. Good. Let's start with Surya Namaskar A, but with a little bit of variation. So bring your big toes to touch and separate your heels. Lift your kneecaps. Engage your quads. Bring your, lengthen the tailbone towards the floor. So bring the pelvis forward and tuck the tailbone under. Gently bring the navel to the spine. Open your heart. Roll the shoulders back. Your chin is parallel to the floor. Crown of the head reach high towards the ceiling. Long neck. You breathe in the energy through the feet. It comes all the way up and is released through the crown of the head. Your arms are relaxed. Tadasana, mountain pose. Lots of space between the ears and the shoulders. Soft gaze. Now bring the hands to the heart. Remember your intention. As you inhale, lift the arms above the head. Maybe find a gentle back bend if you'd like. And as you exhale, fall forward. Inhale, halfway, lengthen the spine. Reach through the crown of the head. Bend the knees, hands to the floor. Find your high plank. Hold your high plank. If you can't hold a high plank, you can always bring the knees on the floor. It's always an option. Now shift forward a little bit so you're more towards the toes. Bend the elbows and come all the way down on the belly. Hands underneath the shoulders. Top of the feet flat on the floor. Now press on the big toenail and lift the kneecaps off the floor. As you inhale, find a baby cobra. So you could even lift the hands off the floor. So you really use the back, the muscles of your back. Relax the glutes. Don't squeeze the glutes too much. And breathe here. Inhale. And exhale to release. Now keep your kneecap lifted. Hands underneath the shoulders. Press on the hand. Inhale. Find a higher cobra. Exhale, twist and look towards the right heel. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist and look towards the left heel. Inhale, center. And as you exhale, lower down. Tuck all 10 toes. As you inhale, press into a high plank. And as you exhale, downward dog. Oh, that was a lot of cracking. Don't know if you could hear that, but oof. Second down dog, if you feel like it, if you need to, you can also walk this one. Press your hips back. Now look forward. Step right foot, left foot, front of the mat. Inhale, halfway up. Lengthen. Exhale, release. So bending the knees if you need to. Press on the feet. Inhale, rise up. Circle the arms around the body. Inhale, all the way to the sky. Exhale, side bend to the right, join the hands, maybe release the index. Inhale, center. Exhale, side bend to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, swan dive all the way down, fall forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway up. As you exhale, step into a high plank. Hold your plank. Wrists underneath the shoulders. Press the heels as if you were pushing against the wall. Now as you inhale, come forward. Exhale, bend the elbows all the way down on your belly. Inhale into a high cobra or maybe a low cobra. Exhale, twist to the left or to the right, either way. Inhale, back to the center. Push your heart forward. And exhale. Twist to the left or the other side. Inhale forward. And as you exhale, lower down. Tuck all 10 toes. As you inhale, press into a high plank. And as you exhale, downward dog. Look forward. Right foot, left foot, step forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, release. Press on the feet. Inhale, rise. And exhale, hands to the heart. Good. Let's move on with two regular Surya Namaskar A. Inhale, rise, back bend if you want. Exhale, fold forward, hinge from the hips. Inhale, halfway, reach forward. Exhale, hop or step to Chaturanga or high plank, low plank. You can even use your knees on the floor. Inhale to an upward dog or cobra. Puff your chest forward, press on the hands. Press on the toenails, strong legs, look up or look forward. And as you exhale, we all meet in downward dog. Find your breath. As you inhale, press back. Exhale, hop or step at the front of the mat. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale to fold. Inhale, rise. Back bend if you'd like. Exhale, hands to the heart. One more. Inhale, tall mountain. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, chaturanga, high plank, low plank. Use your knees if you need to. Inhale, upward dog or cobra, sternum forward. Shoulders sliding down the back. Exhale, use the core, down dog. Find your breath. Inhale, press the hips back. Exhale, hop or step forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, rise. Exhale, hands to the heart. And release. All right, so now we start B with variation. We're not taking a warrior, we're taking high lunge. Arms alongside the body, we'll start with the chair pose. As you inhale, bend the knees, squat down, find the chair pose and hold your chair. Good, now here, make sure you can lift the toes and wiggle the toes. All the energy is towards the midline. Tuck the tailbone under, strong arms, open the fingers. Look towards the horizon. Inhale here. As you exhale, listen, sweep the arms back, chest on top of the thighs, look down. Inhale, find your chair. Exhale, half chair, chest on the thighs, arms sweep back. Two more. Inhale to a chair. Exhale, half chair. Last time. Inhale, chair. Actually, exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, Chaturanga or high plank, low plank, or use the knees. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, lift the right leg high. Exhale, right knee, right elbow. Shift the weight forward. Come into a high plank, but the right knee is towards even the right triceps. Press on the hands, use the core, point the right toes towards the back of the mat. Inhale, three-legged dog. One more time. Exhale, right knee, right triceps. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, step the right foot between your hands, front of the mat. Now here, you don't want to have the butt that sticks up. You want to come forward. You want to be one long diagonal, one long line of energy. Come on the fingertips. Your chest is on top of the thighs. Now as you inhale, lift the arms above the head, crescent, relax the shoulders. Look forward, engage the core, tuck the tailbone under, fingertips reach high. Inhale here. Exhale, hands to the floor. Step into a high plank. Lower down, chaturanga or knees, chest. Inhale, upward dog or cobra. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left leg sweeps high. Exhale, shift into plank, left knee, left triceps. And again, hold here. Make sure you press on the hands, use the core. Point the left toes towards the back of the mat. Inhale, three-legged dog.
Exhale, left knee, left triceps. Inhale, three-legged it up. Exhale, left foot forward between the hands. Shift forward. Make sure the left knee is on top of the left ankle. The right heel is on top of the right toes. Fingertips, chest on top of the thighs. Engage the core. You really want to use the core to have yourself lifted here. Inhale, reach your arms high, find your crescent. Relax the shoulders. Inhale here again. Exhale, hands to the floor. Step into a high plank. Lower down, chaturanga. Inhale for your back bend. Exhale, down dog. Find your breath. Look forward. Hop or step, front of the mat. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees, inhale for your chair pose. And exhale, samasthiti. One more time, let's flow. Inhale to chair. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, chaturanga or high plank, low plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, right leg high. Exhale, right foot forward. Inhale into crescent, check your alignment. Exhale, hands to the floor. High plank, low plank, same exhale. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, left foot forward. Inhale, crescent. Exhale, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Find your breath. Inhale, press back. Exhale, hop or step forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold. Inhale into chair. And exhale, samasthiti. And release. All right, warm up, check. Let's continue. Let's start again with the chair pose. As you inhale, bend the knees, find your chair. Exhale, fold forward, uttanasana. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. And exhale, downward dog. Inhale, reach your right leg high. As you exhale, step the right foot forward between the hands. Inhale, find your crescent. And as you exhale, open to warrior two. Remember, warrior two, you want to have the front heel aligned with the middle of the arch of the back foot. The right knee is pressing towards the right pinky toe. The right knee is above the right ankle. And you press on the other edge of the left foot. Strong arms, soft gaze. Relax the shoulders, open the chest. Pelvis forward, tailbone down. Find some peace and quiet here. Find strength. Find your core. Revolve your front palm. And as you inhale, reverse your warrior. Stretch your right side. Let the left shoulder down. Find a steady gaze, steady drishti. Maybe you want to look forward, you look up. Open the right lung. Inhale here. As you exhale, back to warrior two. Bring the right elbow on top of the right knee and lift the left arm above the head. Stack your shoulders. Now you have options here. You can stay in this variation of extended angle, but don't be here. Press on the left hand bone, lift yourself up. You still want to be one long line of energy from the heel towards the crown of the head, towards your hand. And you roll the left pinky toe towards the floor. Now you can stay with the elbow on the floor, or you can bring the right hand inside of the right foot. You can use your block and bring the block inside of the right foot. And you keep opening. Use the core, open the left lung, and keep pressing the right knee towards the right pinky wherever you are. Now as you inhale, reverse your warrior. And as you exhale, back to extended angle. Keep opening the chest. One more time. Inhale, reverse your warrior, strong legs. The legs don't move, only the upper body. And as you exhale, reverse your warrior. Good, stay here. Now, as you inhale, lift the left arm up so you stack your shoulders and bring the left hand on top of the left hip. Now bring your gaze down. You can use the block. From here, we'll go to half moon. So use the block, put it in front of your foot, or maybe you don't want to use the block. Maybe you want to bring the left foot a little bit closer. Now step on the right foot. As you inhale, lift the left leg off the floor. Open the hip. Flex that left foot, whoops, as if you were pressing against the wall. I'm not gonna erase that. And whenever you have your balance, lift the left arm to the ceiling. So you can gaze down, you can gaze up, and you can try to play with your balance here and see if you can lift the right hand off the floor so you're in a balancing half moon. It's a bit challenging. If you fall, it's fine. Now inhale, as you exhale, step back into warrior two, and lightly, gently, elegantly. Inhale, straighten the right leg, lift the arms above the head, join the palms, and now turn the right foot so both feet are parallel. Good, so now you come towards the long edge of the mat. Open the arms, bring your toes towards the corner of the mat, bend the knees, bend the elbows, find your goddess. Good, now sink a little lower. Again, bring the pelvis forwards and the tailbone down. And now interlace the hands behind the skull, behind the head, open the elbows. Are you ready for this? Inhale here. As you exhale, right elbow, right knee. Inhale, lift yourself up. Exhale, left elbow to the left knee. Smile. Inhale, center. Exhale to the right, touch. Inhale, center. Exhale to the left and touch. One more. Inhale, sink a little lower. And exhale to touch. Inhale, exhale to touch. Back to the center. Lift the arms above the head, relax the shoulder, find your strength. I know it's burning. Keep smiling. Inhale, straighten the legs. And as you exhale, way back to warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, wheel card the hands on the floor, lift the left heel off the floor. Look forward as you inhale. Exhale, find your high plank. You can take a vinyasa or you can go straight to downward dog. Your choice. And we meet in downward dog. And here, take a moment to observe how the left side, the right side feel different. It's always interesting. Connect to the sensations. Stay present. Let's do that on the other side. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left foot forward. Inhale, find your crescent. Exhale, warrior two. Change your feet if necessary. So back foot, parallel to the back edge of the mat. Left knee bend 90 degree. Pinky toe towards the knee towards the pinky toe. Soft gaze forward. Strong arms. Tailbone down, pelvis forward. Breathe. Revolve the front palm. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Open the left lung. Shoulders are sliding down the back. Steady drishti. Roll the pinky finger towards the floor. Inhale here. Exhale, back to warrior two. The lower part of the body doesn't move. Now left elbow on top of the left knee. Lift the right arm towards the ceiling. Now you can stay here, or you can bring the left hand inside of the left foot or on a block. And now lengthen the right arm forward, and again, roll the pinky finger towards the floor. Open the right lung. Press on the outer edge of the back foot. Feel a long line of energy between the thumb and the right heel.
Inhale, reverse warrior. Exhale, extended anger. Inhale, reverse warrior. And exhale, extended anger. Now lift the right arm to the ceiling, stack the shoulders and bring the left hand on top of the right hand on top of the left, the right hip, gaze down. Now bring the left hand in front of the left foot, maybe on a block, and bring the right foot slightly more in. Keep your hips open. Inhale, and as you exhale, find your half moon. Lift the right leg up, flex the foot. So maybe you have the hand on the block, maybe you want your fingertips, maybe on the hand. And when you have your balance, you can lift the right arm up. Shoulders are stacked and hip are stacked. And here again, you can play with your balance. Maybe you want to find a balancing half moon. Or maybe not. Inhale here. And exhale slowly, lightly, warrior two. Inhale, straighten the left leg, arms above the head. And exhale, warrior two. One more time. Inhale. And exhale to warrior two. We'll curl the hands on the floor, lift the back heel off the floor, look forward as you inhale. Exhale, high plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward dog. Find your breath. Inhale, right leg high. Exhale, step the right foot forward. Runner's lunge. Look forward as you inhale. As you exhale, straighten the front leg. Look now towards your right thumb. Your right big toe, I mean. So you should feel a good stretch here in the back of the right leg. One more time. Inhale, look forward. Runner's lunge. And as you exhale, find this variation of pyramid pose. Now flatten the left foot and bring it a little bit more towards the midline. Now you want here to push the right hip back and bring the left hip forward. Inhale here, and as you exhale, now fold over the right leg. You can bring your hands a little bit more towards the middle of the mat. And if you want here a little challenge, maybe with your hand you can grab the left ankle or the left calf muscle. Don't bend the spine, though. Keep a long spine. And keep pulling that right hip back and push it the left hip forward. Now, if you have the whole of the left calf muscle, bring the hands forward and frame the left foot. Hands on your hips, press on the feet, inhale to rise. Keep your hands on your hips. Inhale, lift the left arm up to the ceiling. And as you exhale, we twist. We bring the left hand on the other side of the left foot, of the right foot. Maybe bring the hand on the block. Reverse triangle pose. Now, open the right shoulder. Look up and lift the right arm up towards the ceiling. Reverse triangle pose or revolve triangle pose. Now, if the neck is bothering you, you can gaze towards your foot. Stack the shoulders, but release them away from the ears. And again, try to square your hips. If you're a little wobbly, it's all right. Now inhale here. As you exhale, bring the right hand back onto the floor. Now move the left hand in front of the right foot. Bend the right knee, lift the left leg off the floor. Flex the left foot so the toes are towards the ceiling. You can bring the left hand on top of a block if it's easier. Right hand on your chest. Bring the right hand on your chest. And now revolve your chest to the right and find your reversed half moon. So you want to lift the left leg towards the ceiling. Push the heel back. Keep opening the chest. Keep reaching high with the right hand. Ooh, I'm wobbly. Engage the core so you can twist a little deeper. Inhale here. As you exhale, bring the right hand to the floor
and find your standing split. So here you want to lift the left leg high, high, high. Maybe you can grab the right ankle with the right hand, and you want to bring the chest close to that right thigh and the nose toward the knee. Keep breathing. Release the right ankle. Inhale halfway up. And as you exhale, you can set the left foot on the floor. Inhale halfway up. And exhale, fall forward, Uttanasana. Inhale halfway. Now, you can make a hook with your three first fingers and grab your big toe. Inhale to open. And as you exhale, pull on the toes and fall forward. Maybe you can bring the elbows towards the side. Your tailbone is lifted up towards the ceiling. Chest towards the thigh. Relax the neck. Engage the core to really have a little bit more space between the thighs and the chest. Inhale halfway up. Now bring the right hand onto the right hip, but keep the hold of the right big toe. You can slightly bend the right knee, press on the right foot, and as you inhale, you lift the left leg up so you are in hand to big toe pose. Now if you fell, it's all right. You can also do that with a strap. So you could put a strap on the ball of the left foot so it's easier. Bring the left shoulder back in its socket. Now keep the left leg up, but release both arms towards the ceiling. Inhale here, exhale, hands to the heart, and shift the weight forward and come into warrior three. So the left leg is back, your toes are still flexed towards the floor. You can find here a cobra in your upper body. Inhale here. As you exhale, bend the front knee and find yourself in a high lunge, but with your hands in prayer. Hinge forward. Now twist towards the right. Left elbow hooks on the other side of the right knee. Press on the hands and find your high lunge and prayer twist. Look above your right arm. And breathe. Inhale here. Exhale back to the center. Lift the arms above the head. Hands to the floor. Now find your high plank. Everyone in a high plank. Good. Now maybe you want to open the feet a little bit wider. Come onto the balls of the feet. So here we do shoulder taps. But the idea, you don't want to swing your hips. You want to really keep the body as steady as you can. So engage your quads, engage the core. You can always do that on your knees if you need to. Now, right hand taps the left shoulder and down. Left hand, right shoulder and down. Right hand, left shoulder, down. Left hand, right shoulder and down. Try not to sway the body from side to side. Right hand to the left and down. Left hand to the right and down. One more time. To the right, down, left, down. Inhale, shift forward. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. And as you exhale, downward dog. Find your breath. Ooh, imagine nothing happened. Inhale, left leg high. Exhale, left foot forward, runner's lunge. Inhale, look forward. And as you exhale, straighten the left leg. Keep your upper body parallel to the floor. Inhale, runner's lunge, look forward. And exhale again, straighten the front leg. Now, flatten the back foot and bring it a little bit more towards the midline. And again, make sure your hips are square. So push the left hip back. Draw the right hip forward and the alignment of your feet is heel to heel. Inhale here, and as you exhale, fold over the left leg. Relax the shoulders. Now you can stay here, or you can walk your hands back and maybe grab your right calf muscle, your right ankle, so you can give a hug to that left leg. See what you can do here. Or you can leave your hands even on the block at the front of the mat. Remember, it's your practice. Now bring your hands towards the foot. Inhale halfway up. Bring the hands on your hips. Press on the feet and rise. Lift the right arm above the head. Take a big inhale here. And as you exhale, twist to the left. Right hand on the outside of the left foot. You can bring your hand on the block. Now bring the left hand on top of the chest, revolve the chest to the right, to the left. And as you inhale, lift the left arm up and find your reverse triangle pose. Again, gaze down if you need to. Use a block if you need to. Make sure you keep pushing the left hip back and driving the right hip forward. Use the core. Press on the feet to find stability. If you fall, it's all right. Inhale, and as you exhale, bring the left arm back. Good. Now grab your block or not. Bring the right hand in front of that left foot. Bend the left knee. Lift the right leg off the floor and flex the foot. Find stability here. Again, bring the left hand on top of your chest, revolve your chest to the left, and find your reverse half moon. Strong legs, strong core. Keep smiling. Gaze up or gaze down and keep lifting that back leg. Keep reaching the heel towards the back of the mat. Whoops, I'm wobbly. Inhale here. Exhale to lower down and find your standing split. Lift the right leg up, maybe grab the left ankle with the left hand and keep lifting the right leg towards the ceiling. Maybe bring the knee, the nose toward the knee, the chest to the thigh. Inhale halfway up, and as you exhale, step the right foot to meet the left. Inhale halfway, and exhale forward. Now, grab your big toes with your fingertip, with your three first fingers. Inhale halfway. Exhale, pull yourself down. Crown of the head reaches for the floor. Tailbone is lifted. Chest on top of the thighs. And use your big toes as leverage here. Inhale halfway up. Now bring the left hand on top of the hip. Bend the left knee, press on the left foot. And now, so here you could use a strap on the ball of the right foot, or you lift the right leg parallel to the floor and you find your hand to big toe pose. Press the right shoulders into its socket. Strong left leg. You wanna practice a long spine, so if you need to keep a soft bend in that left knee, it's absolutely fine. Now keep the right leg lifted, but lift both arms above the head. Take a big inhale here, and as you exhale, hands to the heart, and you can find your warrior three. Chest parallel to the floor. Remember to keep a gentle cobra in your upper body. See if you can bring both hips bones facing the floor. Again, imagine that block on top of your sacrum. Inhale here, exhale, bend the front knee and step into a lunge with your hands in prayer. Inhale to hinge forward, exhale, twist to the left. Press on the hands so you can revolve the torso. Again, bring the thumb in front of the sternum. Strong legs, look up. Inhale here, exhale back to the center, inhale, lift the arms up, and as you exhale, hands to the floor,
and find your high plank. Hold your plank. Now bring your feet together and roll onto the right foot. Find your side plank. So you can always bring the right knee on top of the on the floor. You can stagger your feet or stack the feet. And as you inhale, lift the left arm above the head. Not above the head, lift the left arm up. And bump the hips up. You want to look like a banana here. You should feel that in your obliques. Now inhale, reach high. And as you exhale, left arm comes underneath the right chest. And we twist here. Inhale to lift. We do two more of those. And exhale, left arm sweeps under. Inhale to lift. And exhale one more time. Inhale, lift back into your side plank. And as you exhale, gently with control, find your high plank. Feet together, now roll onto the left side. Press onto the left hand, inhale, bring the right arm up. And again, bump your hips up, use the core, use your obliques. Inhale, reach high. Exhale, right arm underneath the left chest. Inhale, lift. And exhale, right arm underneath the left chest. Last time, inhale. And exhale. Inhale to lift. Slowly with control as you exhale, high plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog, and as you exhale, downward dog. Bring your knees onto the floor and find a child's pose here. Find your breath. Now as you inhale, come back onto all fours. Tuck the toes, downward dog. Last downward dog of this practice. Inhale, press the hips back. Exhale, hop a step forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold and release. Inhale, rise all the way to the top. And exhale, hands to the heart. Good. Now, bring your feet together. Bring your arms in front of you with the palm facing down. Come on the balls of the feet. Now lift the arms above the head. Palms facing one another. Now bend the knees a little bit. Keep the legs together. Keep hugging the thighs together. Now straighten the legs. You're still on the balls of your feet. Inhale. And as you exhale, go all the way down. You're sitting on the hips. Bring your hands to your heart. And now see if with control you can flatten the top of your feet. Good. You here? You're with me? Now open the knees and reach your arms forward. Reach your hands forward and round the upper back. And you kind of want here to press the knees against the rib cage. Breathe here. Now inhale, lift the chest, and slowly with control, you can find a seat. Good. You can join, let me just turn towards you. You can bring the soles of the feet together, lift the hips so you come towards the heels. Grab your ankles, plant your elbows in your thighs. Inhale to open, and as you exhale, fall in your butterfly pose. Parakonasana. Oh, it feels good. Try not to round the spine. When you inhale, you reach forward with the crown of the head. And when you exhale, maybe you can bring the knees a little closer to the floor. The idea is to bring the navel towards the heel. It's just an idea, though. Inhale. And as you exhale, release.
Now, if you are not forward, come forward. Extend the arms. Open the palms towards the ceiling gently. Tuck the chin and then roll the spine on the floor. Vertebra by vertebra with control. Good. Then hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a big hug of gratitude for making it up to here in the practice. We are almost done. All right. Good. Now release the soles of the feet on the floor. So we'll do one bridge pose. And then for the second time, you can take another bridge pose. Or if wheel is in your practice, you can take a wheel. If wheel is not in your practice, I strongly suggest that you take another bridge pose. So now you can, if you have a block, you can bring a block in between the thighs. So you remember to keep hugging the thighs together. You can make sure that the fingertips can touch or hover the heels. Now press on the feet on the hands as you inhale, lift the hips up to the ceiling. Clasp the hands underneath the back, roll the shoulders under the back. Keep pressing on the feet, but don't squeeze your glutes too much. Your glutes are engaged, but you shouldn't like over squeeze them. Chin away from the chest. Breathe here. Remember that block or the imaginary block between the thighs. Keep pressing on the feet, bumping the hips up. Two more breaths. Inhale and exhale, slowly release. Good. Now, take a second bridge pose or go to wheel pose. If you go to wheel, fingertips towards the shoulders, elbows towards the ceiling. Don't open the elbows, keep the elbows close to one another. So go for bridge or go for wheel pose. As you inhale, you lift, press yourself up. If you are in wheel pose, you want to really press on the hands, open the chest, arms are strong, and you press on the feet. And you can maybe try to, although we haven't done many back bends today, so maybe the shoulders are not that open, so don't force anything. Two more breaths wherever we are. Now inhale, and as we exhale, we lower down. If you are in wheel, bend the elbows, crown of the head on the floor. Tuck the chin, release the spine on the mat. Bring the knees towards the chest. Give yourself a little squeeze here. And then roll to seated. And let's counter pose that with a forward fold. So straighten the legs in front of you. Inhale, lift the arms above the head. And as you exhale, fold forward. Ooh, that feels good. Remember, fold forward. We want to have the chest on top of the thighs. Even if you are here, it's all right, as long as you have a long spine. Take two more breaths in your forward fold. Inhale, lift the arms up. And exhale, release. Good. And again, extend the arms forward and gently come onto your back. And take a deep stretch here. Reach your arms back, point the toes forward. Inhale and exhale, release. Good. Now draw the right knee to the chest. Open the right arm to the side, palm facing down. Left hand on the outside of the right knee and find a twist here. And if you're lucky, you might hear a little bit of a pop in the lower back. Oh, that feels good. And you gaze towards the right hand. And as we are twisting, you want to breathe deeply. Bring your knee back to the center. Bring the left knee to meet the right. Extend the right leg. Activate the right foot. Open the left arm to the side. And with the right hand, you draw the left knee all the way across. And you gaze to the opposite side. And again, deep breathing. You can close the eyes. Come back to the center. Hug the left knee in, right knee in. Good. Now bring the arms inside of the knees and grab, again, make a hook with your fingers. Make a hook on the big toes and see if you can straighten the legs up. Now, if you have a soft bend in the knees, it's fine. You don't want to have the tailbone lifted. Bring the shoulders back in their sockets. Press the heels towards the ceiling. And again, if you have a strap, you could use a strap here. And now from here, bend the knees, open the knees, and find your happy baby pose. Keep the lower back on the floor. Tailbone might be a little bit lifted, that's absolutely fine. And gently press the knees towards the floor. If you want a bit of movement, you can sway from side to side. Now hug the knees back into the chest. You can here hug your knees really tight and maybe lift the shoulders, the upper back, the lower back. Squeeze yourself here into a little ball. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, you can release in a relaxation pose, Shavasana. Open the legs to the side, let the feet fall out, arms are open with the palm facing up, the head, the neck, the spine, the tailbone are aligned. Take a big breath in, exhale to release. And now let go. Shavasana is a moment you allow yourself and allow the body to dissolve into relaxation. It's a moment you can find some stillness. A moment for the body and the mind to integrate all the benefit of your yoga practice. So allow the physical body to fully soften and fully relax. The upper body is heavy. Lower body is heavy. The back of the head is heavy. You are fully relaxed. Right this moment, there is nowhere to be and nothing to do but be here. For just a few more moments, transitioning between your practice and whatever comes next. But either way, just a few more moments. Stay present with the breath. Now I invite you to stay in Shavasana for as long as you want. Or you can gently start to wiggle the fingers and the toes. Turn the head from one side to the other. Maybe stretch the arms behind the head. Bring your knees to your chest. Gently roll onto the side. And gently press yourself back up to a seated position with your legs crossed, your eyes closed. Find a gentle lift in the heart, reach the crown of the head to the ceiling. Let the breath go back to a vertical position. Place your hands in front of your heart. Come back to your intention. You can also send some gratitude to your body for allowing you to do yoga today. And be grateful to yourself for making the time to be on your yoga mat for this first practice of the year. And to close the practice, we'll chant together the peace mantra, Aum. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Take a deep inhale to chant. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Inhale and exhale. May there be peace in your thoughts, peace in your words, and peace in your heart. Namaste. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for joining this practice. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't hesitate to share away, share with your loved ones, share with whomever needs a bit of yoga in their life. Spread the word that yoga is amazing and helps with everything. I bet you're feeling a lot better now than you did at the beginning of the practice. Go have a big glass of water. Subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell. You know, find me on social media. You know the drill. And I will see you next time.